And welcome back, folks. Welcome back to our Ludum Dare game marathon. Today we're playing up. We are playing Black Planet, a game that I didn't pick because this game was chosen by the random number generator. I hope it will be good. At least the title screen already looks appealing. So let us play. Play. Okay. Okay, you apparently play, shit. You play with the arrow keys. Yeah, you can. Yeah. Press up, the up arrow key to jump. I'm not sure what is, what this little black dot, or this black shape beneath our character is. Maybe it's an artifact. Wait. Actually, are these power-ups? Are these? No, they're not power-ups. Yeah, you just die. Is that all that there is to this game? Okay, what happens if I just jump out of the screen? Okay, then you die. Okay. And if you fall through the ground, you just die. If you do that, then you just die. Okay, and then you die. Okay, it seems that this is really all there is to this game. Just, yeah, jump from platform to platform. This brings, this begs the question, or brings up the question, what's the point of this game? Which actually brings up the point, you could say the meta point, of what's the point of a point anyway, and what's the point of the point, what's the point of having a point in a video game? What does it mean that a video game has meaning or purpose? This is something I have been thinking about recently. I mean, certainly a meaning can be understood at least on one level, as simply the experience of something being meaningful. So meaning in this sense is not a property of the object that you are, for instance, meaning would not be a property of the game, but rather would be just a property of me. If I have the sensation of meaning, then it means that the thing that I'm interacting with has meaning. I would say that video games that, in general, video games that have a story tend to feel more meaningful than video games that don't. Video games that are more abstract, like Tetris or this one, shit, and then I died. Those games, they don't really invoke the same sense of meaning that story-driven games do. Meaning, after all, is just a story. A story that you tell yourself about. Why am I doing this? And the answer will be, well, this story. I mean, certainly, if you look how people, when they are trying to understand something, how they are phrasing their explanations, and in many cases, these explanations, they will be literally stories. So, for instance, in maybe say sciences. Okay, why are you defining this function? Okay, I'm defining this function in order to maybe compute this whatever. So I'm doing this because, and the because it's just the justification of why you're doing that. Or maybe another more fitting example for the point I'm trying to make is let's see whether I can really make this point or not, or whether I'm just rambling here. I'm probably just rambling. Well, I think I can't really explain what I'm... I think I can't really explain this any better, so let's just leave it at that. So, some games feel meaningful and some games don't. And the question is, how do you actually put meaning in a video game? Some games actually achieve... They achieve a sense of meaning that are not story-driven. And the most prominent example, I think, of such a game would be Minecraft. In Minecraft, you basically create your stories yourself. The world in which, yeah. Your Minecraft world is just procedurally generated. The only things that are really man-made, so to speak, are the pre-designed monsters and their behaviors. But the rest is all just the result of some dead and meaningless algorithms. But the meaning in a game like Minecraft is achieved simply by the actions that the player takes and the results, and often unexpected results, that the player has to confront. Just to give some concrete example so that this discussion isn't completely lifeless and bloodless. If you are saying you're doing some mining and you just found this your very first diamond, and then you try to dig it out and you hit a lava reservoir, and then you catch fire and maybe try to find your bucket of water. And you run around like mad because you have forgot where you put all your stuff. And then when you're just on half a heart, you finally figure out where you stored that bucket, but then you're dead. So this would be an example of, well, maybe a story that is a bit tragic and maybe even ironic. It could also be something less violent. You just, maybe see a chicken caught on a tree on top of a mountain, or some irregularly shaped, object. So it could be basically anything. Yeah, so Minecraft is one example of a game that creates, or a game where meaning is being created despite this game not being a story-driven game. So it is an example of a game where you can actually create your own story. Does a game like this have a meaning? It doesn't feel like. It doesn't feel meaningful at all. It's actually pretty mindless, which is... it's a very mindless game, but also very... soothing. It's something that you can really just play without investing too much intellectual capacity into it. Yeah, playing this game in itself is not fun. But playing this game while I ramble on and try to formulate these thoughts and get these things that I've been thinking of recently out of my head actually does feel satisfying. So in this sense, this game could maybe be seen like a canvas, as a tool basically, where you can go and, it's an odd comparison. Maybe a game like Minecraft would be more of a tool that allows you to create your own meaning. Yeah, but I think I will actually come to the end of this video, even though some part of me doesn't want to stop and just continue on playing and thinking about things. It does have a hypnotic quality to it, I must give it that. Well, anyway, this was Black Planet, and if you stuck to the end of this video, then you are clearly insane. Even more insane than I am. But if you did, then thanks, and I hope to see you in the next video. If you want to experience this game for yourself, this is a browser game, in fact. There's a link to the game in the description. So, I hope you enjoyed this video. Until next time, folks. Until then.